move here. We've only got one missile left. Approaching 110 miles, sir.
God damn it.
I got him. He's right on us. He's between our tails.
Thank you.
Shoot. 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 Shoot.
Altitude. Altitude.
Shoot. 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 Shoot.
from the silver screen to the skies, exploring the naming of the F-22 Raptor. When the United States Air Force set out to christen its revolutionary next-generation fighter jet, speculations were abound. Many names had already been used, such as the Lightning II, Superstar, and the Rapier, which is actually a small knife, so yeah, that didn't stick. The project was over budget, and it was under scrutiny, and the United States Air Force needed something big, so why not draw inspiration from the world of cinema and choose to honor the stealthy predators of Jurassic Park and name the aircraft the F-22 Raptor. This video essay explores the captivating story behind the surprising name decision and the significance of the name Raptor for this formidable fighter jet. The ATF program, initiated in the late 1980s, aimed to develop an advanced tactical fighter to ensure air superiority in future battles. As the program progressed and Lockheed Martin was awarded the contract, rumors suggested that the chosen aircraft would be christened the Lightning II, paying homage to the legendary predecessors like the P-38 Lightning and the F-4 Phantom. And the first prototype, which was produced in the 1990s, was originally named the Lightning II. Well, that is before the company changed its name to the Superstar. Bet you Adidas would have loved that. But ultimately, Lockheed only gets to suggest the names to the military, and in this case, General Doolittle didn't like the name Superstar, and he wasn't keen on naming it after his old favorite plane, the Lightning II, and was really reaching for a name, and above the desk in the conference room is a display of a Rapier which caught the general's eye. So yeah, the United States Air Force went with the Rapier. Well, not exactly. See, Admiral Betancourt saw the name change listed, and everyone knows an admiral is higher ranked than a general in the Air Force. Anyways, he saw that name change to Rapier and said it sounded too much like the French water Perrier, which is weird because it doesn't sound anything like it. But the rumor is the admiral still despised the French from an old injury he received during the war. But you see, the thing is, the war wasn't in France, and he heard himself trying to open a bottle of French dressing. But everyone knows a admiral outranks them, so he suggested some names to his staff sergeant that were horrible. I mean, stuff like the Poodle, also consequently French, and Monster for a royalty deal with the drink company, which I'm pretty sure is not even legal. Anyways, the staff sergeant tells him about the new movie Jurassic Park and suggests maybe naming it after the movie, which doesn't really roll off the tongue, F-22 Jurassic Park. But the idea stuck in the admiral's head. And when something gets stuck in the admiral's head, it can never leave it, just like that arrow from the French and Indian War. So to make a long story short, the admiral shoots the movie idea by the general, because everyone knows an admiral outranks a general. And the general says, that's a terrible idea, blah blah blah, legal this, blah blah blah, legal that. And so they name it the Park, after Jurassic Park, of course. So they start getting the name ready, you know, like making the letters and the t-shirts, and they're having a big party and a parade. Yay, yay, the Park, and stuff like that. And the president hears about it. I believe it was one of the presidents, like Nixon. And he's like, oh, hell no, that name is horrible. And he tells them to name it the Raptor. And that's how I got the name the Raptor. I mean, this is a true story. You can ask my Uncle Lou if you don't believe me.
Space. Russians invade.